Step 7 of translating your WordPress website using WPML is what we refer to as testing. So when we refer to testing, we mean that we want to make sure all of the content you want translated is being translated. Because of the complexities of WordPress's backend, there are a lot of considerations you need to make. For example, custom fields, menus, SEO content, and other slugs will need to be considered. So a few examples of those might be a button up here or the menus, as I mentioned. So there's a little bit different of a process to send that content through WordPress. So to do that, you would go to the WPML tab and then the taxonomy translation section. You'd pick whichever specific taxonomy categories you'd like translated, and then you can either add them to the basket, or you may click on the plus sign here and you can export this content into Excel and send that for translation. Another consideration in testing is that we can set up an automatic workflow where you would push all of the content you'd like translated through WordBBBox, and then we would push back content in all capital letters. That's an easy way to do a quick eyeball test on your site to make sure that all the content you want translated is being translated. Alternatively, if there's content you don't want translated, that's a good test as well, because if it remains in lowercase, you can see that as well. And that completes step 7 of translating your WordPress website using WPML, which is testing.